Early Liberty by Rita Anderson. Act 2, Scene 1. Lights up on an empty room with a window upstage left. Gall leads a beat Mark into one of the unfinished hideaway bungalows Selma had mentioned. In the room are materials for remodeling.
Now, it ain't much to look at, but that's where you come in. Now, it's like I told that naval officer when I bailed you out. This guy, he is good people, no matter what the charges say. And you wouldn't make a fool of me, now would you, Mark? Now, so, man to man, you punched the wall, and Connie's got a broken rib? Mm-hmm. Hell, I am sorry for your misfortune, but it couldn't come at a better time. I got this place and one just like it got bashed up pretty bad in ISIS. I figured that I had scratched your back, and now you can.
Thank you, sir. I really don't know how I can repay you.
Oh, you'll be singing for your supper.
For standing up for me.
Now, they find the hell out of you, but you'll be staying here for free. I mean, that is, you'll be working it out in trade. And who's to say? I mean, if the charges stick and you are discharged, you can come aboard here full time, as grounds manager said. Now, in situations like this, you got to look on the bright side, and their loss is my gain. Work was always my release, and it might do you some good to take up that bottled up aggression out on an empty room instead of your wife's face.
I never hit her, sir.
Well, in any event, I put a lien on the hotel to raise your bail, and I want you here to protect my investment. So you hunker down and don't be running up the utilities, you hear? Now stay plenty warm working up a sweat. You're good with your hands, no? And you had a paycheck coming.
Two, actually, sir.
Well, you won't be living high on the hog here, and I don't want you leaving the grounds.
I understand the terms of our agreement, sir.
Now, I posted bail, so this will be on my terms, like a period of supervised detainment.
William, can we wrap this up?
I'll be right down, doll.
Recruited for this gig, 2 years. And now that my foot's in the door, I won't lose the opportunity. Time is no model's friend.
You are gorgeous. And we're finishing up.
And I'm freezing my tits off outside.
Then I'll just have to buy you a new pair.
You're a regular laugh riot. Now, let's go.
Our flight doesn't leave for over an hour yet.
I'm cranking up the heat in the Lincoln. It's your gas.
You do what you need to do, darling.
Hey, doesn't your daughter still live here?
Oh, she moved out on her birthday.
What a loser.
The nail that sticks out gets hammered.
What?
The world's meaner than it looks, and Selma, she's the most original person I've ever met.
She's so strange. I hated her since high school.
You were years ahead of her.
Point being, no, we were in home ec and typing together, and the classes did a joint project and making our wedding albums, but Selma refused. She said it was dumb.
She did spend a lot of time in detention.
But whatever, I'm bored. Thought if she was still hanging around, I could go rub this convention thing in her face.
Well, some things just never change.
What a dump.
Which brings me to my last order of business. Now, how's a man supposed to raise to the top of his game when he's strapped all this dead weight? He ain't. Now, Vivian here, she says there are takers and givers in this world, and that's my turn to take. She's got a friend with friends, and there's big money for hotels that book the convention circuit. Now, there's been a last-minute cancellation, so I am taking my first vacation in 20-some years. It's kind of freeing. Hey, you vacation much as a kid? How about you and Connie? I mean, like, you know, before.
Yeah, there was always too much to do. We didn't have the...
Yeah, time, right? Yeah, you and me, we're a lot alike, Mark.
I wanted to be like my... Father, he made it all look so easy.
Well, my father didn't walk on water, and I used up my magic keeping you from the brig. Now, I'm not comfortable leaving the Lighthouse Cove, but it's still really just a business trip, right?
I'll handle things, sir.
Yeah, you'll have to.
When will you be back?
Now, this is an early Paddy's Day convention, said I'll be peeing green for a month. But I'll be back, you know, first day of spring, 2 weeks, so chop chop. And if we get that open slot, I'll need all the space I got. Now here, there's grocery money. I'm afraid there wasn't much left of your paycheck.
Paychecks, sir. Yes, sir.
Paychecks. But there was a lot of cash missing from the night of your arrest.
What? Damn it, Jude.
Now, I haven't mentioned it because you were in enough trouble. You know, water under the bridge. But I've deducted it from your pay. And after I bought these supplies, well, that's the remainder. And two more housekeeping details. I think I told you, but my wife's had a relapse. Now, she was always so fragile. But she's in the hospital permanently this time.
What's happened to Miss Gall?
Well, we're not too proud of it, but Zelda's ill. There's no fixing crazy, so they've, the treatments have, it's calmed her, okay? She won't be able to harm herself anymore is the thing.
What about Selma, sir? Does Selma know?
No, I don't want her to. Seems she's finally doing something with herself, so my little shove worked. But she's always been excessive and desperate, you know, so like Zelda. Anyway, it's only a matter of time now, isn't it? Because Selma's already showing signs.
Sure, Selma's spirited, sir, but...
Onwards and upwards, right? Anyways, as agreed, you are exclusively mine until the hearing, but I'm leaving. So fax these reports on you and the property, one per week. Now, the number's on the sheet.
Sir, this all makes me very uncomfortable.
Grow up then, Mark, because none of us has much choice in the cards we're dealt. Now, I gotta go. So held down the fort. And hey, I enjoy our talks.
All exits, lights out. Scene 2. Lights up low through the window to signal just after sunrise. Mark is asleep in a sleeping bag. Plastic and blue tape hangs where fixes have been made. Selma sneaks in with a boombox. She has been beat up and is letting her eyes adjust when she sees the body, which is Mark.
Stop! Help! Somebody!
What the? Selma, is that you?
Who's there? Because I got a gun.
What are you doing with a gun, Selma? It's Mark. Stop shouting. It's me.
Mark goes to turn on the light. Selma frees her hair from the scrunchie and it falls over her face. There's a faint sound of waves.
Don't turn on the light, Mark. No.
What's going on?
What are you doing here?
I ask you first.
Daylight means real job. Why aren't you out diving shipwrecks or changing poopy diapers or whatever it is that you do with your fucking perfect organized life?
Why are you back?
I don't know why you're hiding out here, but you'll have to leave. Daddy will be none too pleased to see me back. 3 weeks. 3 goddamn weeks. But I'll talk to him, see? I'll beg and say I just need some time, a little more time. I'll clean rooms until I figure it out. But you? He'll kill you, Mark, if he knows you're stowing away out here.
He knows, Selma, but you don't sound...
You are always interested in the hideaway bungalows, but this is a little, even for you. And what do you mean he knows? What does he know?
You're talking crazy.
I'll tell you what's crazy. It's you. You're always so damn in control that it's out of control.
Are you drunk, Selma?
Where is he, Mark? Where's Gall? Because I went home, see? Poof. Nothing but the tick-tock of the click-clock. No mom, no dad.
How much have you had to drink?
He starts looking for a bucket.
Oh, I'm gonna lose my freaking mind. Help me, it's begun.
What's begun?
Final curtain. Oh, sweet mother, I'm gonna be sick.
She pukes in a bucket. Mark holds her hair.
What's happened to your face? Selma?
What's wrong with your hand?
Who the hell did this to you?
I was only there because of you.
I'm sorry.
I don't forgive you for helping him kick me out, you rigid, rule-worshipping shitface. But where is Daddy? What have you done with him?
He's gone. But he'll be back.
Gone? What do you mean he's gone? Oh, God. Help me.
He's on vacation.
See? Now I know you're lying. Why are you lying to me? I gotta get out of here.
He'll be back. I promise. But stay, Selma. Please.
Get out of my way. This is crazy talk. He wouldn't leave. God never leaves.
He hired me. He hired me to stay here. You can stay with me.
With you? I hate you.
Mark tries to keep her from leaving without actually touching her.
Then what about your old room? It's still vacant.
He'll find me. That's the first place he'd look.
That biker jerk off? You've got to stop putting yourself in the wrong place at the wrong time. It's just, it's asking for trouble.
Get out of my way.
Where will you go?
What difference does it make?
I could take you to a doctor's.
Been poked and prodded my whole life.
What is this about? What are you trying to say?
I am at the end of my road.
Your rope, you mean? The end of your rope?
Out of options. Nothing sticks, and I have nobody. You know that.
I'm your friend. I'll be a better friend, okay? Listen, here. You can have my sleeping bag.
After the way you sold me down the river?
Stay, Selma. You'll be safe here.
Safe? What is safe? And for how long?
I insist. Please. You're obviously in trouble.
It's shape up or ship out in this world. Guess that's my answer. God, it's ugly. I'm in the darkest of shit places, down in the tar with my mother, before her time, in her prime.
Don't go. Look, I can't lose one more person, Selma. I need to know you'll be okay.
Well, I'm not okay. Okay? Not even close.
I understand.
Yeah, right, Mr. Button Down.
Listen, I've got my own tar pit, Selma. I understand because I'm in trouble too.
Lights out. Scene 3. Lights up on Selma sitting on Mark's sleeping bag. Plastic is off the walls and the window is curtained. Donald looks into her boombox, very upbeat, making a scrapbook out of magazines. Mark enters with groceries and a sleeping bag.
You're up. Good. Are you hungry?
More than up. Been busy. Ta-da! I swept and hung curtains. I even made clovers for the multi-purpose tree. Aren't they shiny? And now I'm working on the future.
All this before lunch.
Can't call it lunch when it's 3 p.m., but I work through the night. Where have you been?
I've been bunking in the office, so not to bother you.
Can't believe I conked out for like 3 days straight, but I got exactly the right amount of sleep, and now I'm ready to fight dragons and save babies.
Here, look, maybe your own setup will help you when you're ready to sleep again.
You're always so thoughtful, Mark, but I don't know how you can sleep in these things. It's so constricting, like a body bag.
Well, that's the point. They keep the heat in, but if you were up all night, then why don't you try and lay down?
Because like I said, slept for 3 days, and now my mind's exploding with ways to improve this place. Not just our place, your place. The whole blasted hellhole. And we'll strike while the iron's hot, because Daddy's out drumming up customers, right?
It's good to see you back to your old happy self.
Mark stacks non-perishables in the corner.
Thought you weren't supposed to leave the premises.
I just went to the mom and pop a few blocks over.
That's how bad habits are started. You blur the boundaries inch by inch until...
Is this really you telling me to color inside the lines?
When do they make the determination?
48 hours.
And then it's done. And you'll know?
What are you working on that's got you in such a buzz? Can I see?
Only the answer to all of our problems. Not that I wouldn't love to depart from this nautical theme, but working from where we are, here is, drum roll, the Titanic room, designed to look like one of the ship's cabins. It'll have a waterbed, and we'll sell white Starline Russians at the bar.
What bar?
The nightclub I want to build. I'd planned, remember? All the games for down at the bar, which I can't go to anymore, thanks to Psycho. But that's okay, because I've stopped drinking.
Since when? I mean, you have?
And I have all this energy now that I'm not drinking myself into oblivion. But, so yeah, people are dazzled by spectacle. And tragedy, I guess, especially the monstrous kind.
Lighthouse Cove is going to have a Titanic room.
They're so close to finding that ship, Mark. It'll be any day now, and we'll be ahead of the crowd. It's perfect timing.
It's not too morbid or like sending out some kind of strange message.
You're not even giving it a chance.
Are all the rooms going to be named after famous wrecks?
Or we'll make the Titanic our honeymoon suite, since most unions sink quicker than the ship did.
Gong.
But I've just started. You hate them?
That last train of thought, yes. But no, you have a knack for this.
He'll never go for it.
She starts to rip the picture, but he stops her.
Keep going.
Or we could do classic movies like Wizard of Oz and Gone with the Wind. Rear Window could be like our swanky divorcee suite, and Jaws could be the pool area.
What pool?
The pool we'll add.
Right next to the nightclub that doesn't exist.
Yeah, a bar with one side open so swimmers can paddle up to get a drink.
Why?
It'd be cool, for one, and because life is so beautiful in the movies.
Who wants an unhappy ending?
It's what people live for, the fantasy.
Not everyone.
Yes, everyone. Why? What do you want out of life?
I already told you, I don't know.
Well, then there's your problem. You're like a swarming hive.
I'm like a beehive.
All this activity, activity, activity. It's empty, Mark. Life's about paying attention to the right things. You're all buzz and no honey.
As a gentleman, I am done with this conversation.
It's not your fault. You can't aim at what you don't know you want.
I'd like to hold my family together, not lose my daughter, who is the only reason I get up each morning. So, okay, maybe that is a fantasy right now.
And Connie?
Not necessarily.
Did you ever love her?
I don't know.
Boy, we've got a lot of work to do on you.
Or maybe it's you, Selma. Did you ever think that maybe you just dream too much?
It takes all this dreaming just to keep me on my feet. And I'll need every feather I can stuff into these wings to lift us out of the pit we're in. But this isn't about your lack of vision, Mark. It's about giving folks what they want. Why rent a hotel with the same old you got at home when you could have theme rooms? It's going to be the next big craze. Like with our room service guys.
Chris?
Right after the pool bar. Yeah, they'll dress like Tarzan or Jane when they deliver your orangutan fries to the jungle room.
That's not too tacky. Virginia tourists aren't exactly itching for Vegas.
I've trended long enough to know what's hot and what's not.
Finish your blueprints then, Princess Leia. This drone has got to get back to the real world of dirty carpets.
A series of solar system rooms would be cool too, and it'd be a blast to design a cosmic menu.
Promise me you'll eat something.
Children are starving in Ethiopia. Think I can miss a meal. Later, okay? You've just given me so many great ideas, I gotta jot them all down.
It wouldn't hurt to play the lottery then, because none of what you're talking about comes cheap.
Mark exits. Selma draws furiously. Lights out. Scene 4. Lights up on Selma, dancing. Hours after supper, the tablecloth is on the floor with Chinese food, wine, and two mismatched candles on top of it. Selma blows out the candles and walks to the window, then the door, peering out. Keeps moving a letter written in a woman's hand. She has leaned it against the wine when a drunken Mark stumbles in.
Punched a hole in the wall, okay? I did it, and I shouldn't have. It was married housing, and all birthing is government property. I get that. I do. I need to control your anger before it controls you.
He tries to take off his coat, but is tangled. Selma helps to free him.
You smell like a brewery.
Bingo! Give the lady a dolly. Now you know how I felt all those nights you popped in at the front desk looking like you'd slurped your way to the bottom a la Lake Vodka.
Selma moves to the picnic she's arranged.
So you were arguing with Connie?
On the day in question, yeah. What else is new?
It's just that I haven't been able to get you to talk about that night.
More and more. That's all we did. Different day, same channel. But then she tried to keep me from leaving. She stood in the bedroom doorway and she slapped me across the face.
And is that when you hit her back?
I pushed her aside to get through the door and yeah, to keep from knocking her lights out. But she ran after me and tripped down the front stairs, breaking a rib and bruising a cheek.
No witnesses.
Her word against mine.
And you're telling the truth.
I shouldn't have pushed her. I had to get away.
Been trying to get away my whole life.
See, that's just it. I thought about what you said about not knowing what I want, and I realized I did know. I don't want out.
You don't?
Out of the Navy. Maybe not this way, but I hated what I did.
All that talk about shipwrecks and diving.
I got a problem with my ears. The only diving I ever did was for box of paper clips. I ordered supplies for a living, Selma. I was a storekeeper.
And the marriage?
We're not quitters. Real men don't abandon their families. Who's the letter from?
Selma gets up to hide Connie's letter. To deflect, she raises her sleeve and shows a bandage.
Free Clinic's got a new test to bring some peace of mind to the dating scene, and waiting was terrifying, but whew, clean as a whistle. But maybe it is time for a new leaf.
So that's your test results? Then who's the letter from, Selma? Is that for me?
Later, maybe. Have dinner while it's still cold. Don't you just love Chinese?
Mark leans around Selma to take the letter. He scans it and then rips it up.
Liberty, liberty, liberty. Liberty is hereby granted to all authorized personnel to expire on board at 0700 on the 12th of never. Now, liberty.
He opens the window and throws out the papers and his wedding ring, waves and wind.
What's that mean, Mark?
It means you're relieved of your duty early, whether you want to be or not. It's like a holiday you didn't know was coming.
You can't save everyone.
I can't save anyone.
No one can, but there's hope.
There is? Where? And for what?
Then you. And for us? Yes, I have hope.
How? We're tiny people, Selma. We're like lint in the pocket of life.
But hope is hope. It's the paper boat that keeps you afloat. It's free, Mark, and it's for everyone, especially people like us.
I wish I had your faith.
You're basically decent, and it's like you're finally coming to. We'll get better, you and me. I think we're just under the weather.
This dark cloud is like my very own isolated curse.
But doesn't being scared let you know that you're onto something important?
dishonorably discharged, and a divorce decree. Could this day have any more impossible suck to it? Amazing.
He uncorks the unopened wine.
For the lovely lady?
No, thanks. I bought it for you.
Was that before or after Connie's letter arrived?
I'm on your side.
I know. God, I'm so pathetic. You do so much with so little, Selma. Look what you did for me here with the picnic in the middle of the floor and everything. Connie never, not once. Her idea of romance was payday. Not to say you were being romantic. I'm sorry.
What if I was?
What?
It's just that I watch you, Mark. I see how you want to fix, I don't know, everything.
Well, I thought I wanted to, but I can't. I kill everything. It's just like I told you when you gave me that tree. God, that was sweet, Selma. You're really very sweet.
But that's what I don't get. If you're so into broken things, then why don't you like me?
I do like you, Selma.
Not the way that I like you.
I don't know what you mean.
Liar.
You're calling me a liar.
Well, you lied about your job and how bad it was for you at home.
I just never spoke of it.
That's one way of lying.
Fascinating. Look, if I'm a liar, then what does that make you? I've met your mom. She's very sick. You're not going to shake this up and walk away.
I lost her, okay? Who cares how? And you should talk. You're a fish who can't swim.
It's better than being a fish out of water.
That's the same thing, Mark.
Well, who the hell can keep track? You're all over the map. First, we're birds of a feather and abandoned buildings, and then I'm an empty hive, and now it's a fish?
I'm confusing. You say you don't want out when your whole life is one screwed up contradiction.
So I'm sick of my life. I am, but at least I started mine.
It has taken me longer than most to figure out what I don't want, okay? But what courage does it take to live a lie? At least I have a pulse. At least I'm not asleep standing up.
At least I'm not sleeping with everyone.
Don't you mean anyone?
Tell me, Selma, do you ever say no to yourself?
Do you ever say yes?
I thought you were different.
I know that you're special.
Mark moves to erase a future he's imagined before it can appear.
This was a mistake.
You haven't done anything.
Mark grabs her, and they kiss desperately.
I've never been with anyone but Connie.
And I've never been in love before.
I don't want to disappoint you.
Look at me. I never want what's good for me, but I want you. And I love that you're so, I don't know, grounded, I guess, and reliable.
Well, don't make it sound so sexy.
Are you serious? After the circus of my life, nothing sexier. Being with you makes me feel like I have sunshine in my chest.
You look so pretty like this.
You mean plain?
When you're not trying to be anybody else. And your hair.
It's got its own weather forecast.
It's such a delicate mess.
That's me.
It's beautiful. You're beautiful. But we don't have to do this.
If all I had was today of being in your arms, it's the happiest accident of my life. Be with me, Mark. Just be with me.
They join sleeping bags. Lights out. Scene 5. Days later, lights up on the front desk. Dressed like Flashdance, Selma wears the gloves and leg warmers that Mark bought her. She hands a key to a customer before replacing the clovers on the tree with a rainbow of mini Easter eggs.
Honeymooners!
On our way back, actually. Headed home. We stopped because of the snow.
So happy to share your joy, but bear with us. My husband and I are renovating, so keep an eye out for the mailer I'll send you for your next discounted visit. And I'll bring up complimentary muffins and coffee for you lovebirds in the morning, right after your wake-up call. Tomorrow's the first day of spring.
Oh, may I have one of those four-leaf clovers?
Hope it brings you half the joy that it brought me.
The woman exits, and Biker enters with a box. Hearing the bell, Selma turns, smiling.
Hello again. Did we forget something? A toothbrush?
Oh, hey yourself, pretty lady. It's you who forgot something. You can get that if I were you. The box came in the mail. I was gonna pitch it, and then I started thinking about the balls you had living under my roof and ordering this for your fucking boyfriend.
He'll be back any minute.
Oh, is that supposed to scare me, you stupid bitch?
What do you want, Frank?
No one calls me that. Stop calling me that, but I had to get something for my efforts.
Money's in the till.
No, I had something better or wetter in mind.
He pulls out a switchblade. Jude enters.
I don't know, Jude. How is a blonde different from a toilet seat? Well, a toilet seat doesn't follow you around after you. Okay!
Jude looks up, drawing his gun.
You pull a gun on me, fuckwad, you'd be better to be ready to use it.
Jude discharges the real gun. It hits Reagan's picture, which falls.
I have the right to bear arms, and you have the right to get the hell out of here this second, or the second bullet's got your name on it. Fuckwad.
Asshole's got a record. Police will snatch him up in a heartbeat. Same address, then? Brank.
Selma picks up the phone as the biker throws the box at Jude and exits.
You, again? Do you really think I should call the police?
Lady, I am the police. It's mostly official.
How's anyone sort of the law?
Temporary crisis with the no-fork force. Guess I was in the right place at the right time. They got a bad case of the blue flu, so I got called in.
If you crossed a picket line, then you're a scab.
With help, I passed the test. They deputized me, and bam, mostly traffic detail. I'm waiting for a permanent position, which they can't do until the union backs off, and they're mostly mafia, that's what I heard. But, damn, now I've got to fill out paperwork for discharging my weapon.
I'll vouch for you. We all got to help each other, right?
Well, I did just save your life, didn't I?
Selma hangs eggs on the tree.
But I could do without the blonde jokes. Know any short men jokes?
Sorry, I thought Mark was here.
Mark talks like that with you?
Wait, so Mark's gone then? Shit, was hoping to reach him before he left.
Where'd he go?
Well, don't you know? Seems he thinks I owe him money, again.
What'd he need money for?
No offense, but why should I tell you about his personal business? You're not going to try and get him fired or anything.
My father's hired him to do some remodeling.
She opens the box and pulls out a Route 66 sign.
We're giving the hotel a facelift, Mark and me, right after we take a road trip down Route 66 before it ceases to exist. Take a real vacation, together.
Smiling, she writes on the back of the sign.
So you're what, like boyfriend, girlfriend? Then how come he's never mentioned you?
Who are you to talk? What's your name?
Well, he's still married, and I'm Jude, as in Mark's best friend.
So where is he, then? I've covered his shift the last two nights.
Well, funny you should say road trip, because that's where he's at.
Fine. So when is he coming back?
If he's gone, I don't think he's coming back.
You don't think he's... Wait, why?
Well, yeah, he called for gas money, I guess. I didn't get the message, my mom did.
Just like that? No goodbye? Did I do this? God, I come on like a freight train.
Back home, maybe. Fresh start, new life. Picked up Callie.
And Connie?
Yeah, I don't know what happened with that restraining order.
You know about that?
I'm his best friend, ain't I?
But Connie filed for divorce. And Mark left Callie's photo. No way he'd leave this behind if he was going to disappear.
I don't see why he'd need a photo if he had his daughter in his arms. No telling. Connie and Mark must have patched up their scargument.
Scargument?
Well, you mean more than an argument. A fight so bad it leaves scars.
Is there any other kind?
Look, what do you want me to say? Family's family.
I can't do this again.
What?
Nothing. It's nothing. So you coming or not?
Me? Well, I thought you said you and Mark were...
You're my hero, right? You won the door prize.
Oh, damn. Where to?
Does it matter?
Guess not. Take me to your leader.
Wow, okay. Hey, Jude. You thirsty?
Hell yeah. All this excitement's got my blood pumping. Let's fan these flames.
There's an all-night package store up the street, but wait outside. Gotta lock up.
So cool. Like one of them Playboy forums. Nothing like this ever happens to me.
Look after your dad. Okay, sweetheart. And they come onto 66 from the tributary side roads, from the wagon tracks, and the rutted country roads. 66 is the mother road, the road of flight.
She tosses the sign into the trash. It hangs out. Phone ring. She considers answering, but exits. She runs back on stage to answer the phone.
Lighthouse Cove, this is Selma. I'm so sorry, you have the wrong number.
Selma goes into the inner office, returns with the gun, and exits. Lights out. Scene 6. An hour later, Jude and Selma move wildly. Selma in Mark's room. Jude attempts the moonwalk and the robot. They've painted a red bullseye on the wall and drink from a giant vodka box.
Oh, what will we do now that we're done with the bullseye?
This.
Damn, where'd you get the pistol?
Better shut up and shoot.
I got no bullets in my gun.
You fired something. At the president, no less. Not that you were the first. When you can't make him see the light, then make him feel the heat. Ain't that right, Mr. President? But won't Daddy be pissed? But not pisser than we're getting. Come on, catch up. We're drinking ourselves to the muddy bottoms of Lake Vodka.
I don't know. No, we ain't allowed to walk around with our guns fully cocked. Not me, anyways.
Selma pushes the gun into Jude's hands. He shoots 2 rounds.
Bullseye. You're a damn good shot, Haas.
What's my prize?
Strip poker.
Best stinking day of my life.
But it's my turn to shoot first.
She fires 2 rounds and Jude falls.
Jeez, you trying to kill somebody? Where are the cards? You got cards?
Deck's there, by the window.
All right. Jokers, a wild, and so are 8s.
8s? It's so weird that you said that. Why say 8s?
Dealer's choice. I don't know. Look, I'll go first.
Trust you're not this quick a draw in bed.
Ma'am?
One of these days I'll learn to keep my big mouth shut. So you're a police officer. Ever seen a dead body before?
I win. You gotta take something off.
Selma peels her bra from under her shirt.
I kind of did.
Did what?
Saw a person who died.
What? Where?
I was 8, and I'd run out to see if anyone could play before Daddy called me in for supper. And there was Vivian and Peter. They were passing a picture and laughing the kind of laugh where maybe you shouldn't be laughing at whatever it is you're laughing at. These were older kids who never wanted to bother me, but I said hi, waiting to be ignored, and Vivian said, "How old are you again?" Peter hid the photo, like, "She's too young." "I'm not," I'd insisted. Too young for what? I couldn't imagine what was so bad that they couldn't show me. But the truth is, I was tired of being left behind. You saw my mom. She lived in her sickness, so Daddy stayed at work. More than wanting to be smart about the world like those kids, I wanted to belong somewhere, you know?
Jude stands up and unzips his jeans.
I looked. Do you understand? Saw the dead girl in the photo that Peter had stolen from his dad's police files. Looked like she'd fallen asleep and spilled spaghetti and there was nothing in her eyes. No pain. No peace. No life. Right then, like, how did she know? But Mommy runs out in her underwear yelling, "Leave her alone!" But it was too late. And as I ran home to tuck her back into bed, with Vivian and Peter laughing at me now, I knew there would be no going back to the fill-in-the-blanks of coloring books.
Well, they say a picture paints 1,000 words.
But why does no one tell you that those images also last 1,000 years? Now, when I picture it, that girl's pain is as close as my own breath. And cruelty isn't faceless.
I think I'm winning. I am losing my drawers.
He takes off his shoes and socks.
Got a better idea.
Nothing's better than this.
Let's raise the stakes. How about some Russian roulette?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know about that.
Selma turns off the light. There's moonlight. A breeze from the broken window blows curtains in the air. Sound of crashing waves.
Got any parting words for the waiting world?
Hey, stop playing around. Wait, I just realized I don't even know your name.
What do you, makes you think I'm playing?
I don't like this.
There's one bullet left and I'll go first. Well, that wasn't so bad. I've survived round one.
Oh, I peed my pants a little, I think.
Your turn, Jude.
Holy shit, I'm alive. Oh, wow, what a rush. What a fucking rush that is.
And here's to an early liberty. What do you know? Can't win for losing. Guess it's your turn, Jude.
Whoa, I don't want another turn, no.
Don't be such a baby. All right, fine. This was dumb anyways.
They fight over the gun.
Will you stop? Dude, just give me the...
Lights out. Scene 7. Lights up. Front desk. Daylight. Police is on the phone.
We responded to anonymous tips. There is one casualty, gunshot victim. Coroner says it looks like suicide. No. Nothing we can do. There's popcorn shrimp everywhere.
Mark enters with wildflowers. Police brush past Mark.
Hey, excuse me, I work here. Is someone hurt? Who's hurt?
Police talks into his two-way radio.
Body's been released. Paramedics need help getting that gurney off the beach.
Off the beach? What happened?
Police exits. Gall at the door yells out.
They have to trample through the courtyard. And are you going to drag this out until the whole world knows my business? I mean, how much longer is this going to take? I got a big wig from a hotel chain coming to make an offer on the property in an hour. And this is not the homecoming I'd imagine.
You're going to sell Lighthouse Cove?
Gall sees Mark and flies at him.
This is your fault. What the hell was she doing in your room? And why did you leave her alone with a gun?
Will somebody please... Tell me what's going on.
You lost your family, so you saw to it that I lost mine too.
Not Selma. Please, no. Tell me it wasn't Selma.
Of course it was. Who else?
Stop talking about her like that. I called. No one picked up.
You want to leave the property.
Until they discharge me, yeah, but... Connie had to leave base housing, and we only have one car, so I had to drive her and Callie to North Carolina where her folks are.
What, and you couldn't tell somebody?
Who and how? Connie taxied over here hysterical during my shift. She was screaming at me, and Callie was crying in her arms, and there were all her suitcases.
The men sit side by side, exhausted, as two police enter. One is Jude.
First man on the scene, huh? How'd you get the call before the rest of us?
Sir, we're going to have to ask you to step outside and identify the victim.
It's his daughter, for God's sake. Show some respect. What are you doing here?
And I thought you'd sailed off into the sunset.
Why would you think that?
Come on, or do we need to bring this man in for questioning?
No. Suicide is just nature's way of taking out the trash.
Mark punches Jude. Police pin Mark. Jude pulls police off of Mark.
We're not gonna press charges.
Got the camera? So we need to get those pictures developed. For the files.
Jude exits with his counterpart.
They said there were two signs of two people in the room. It can't have been you then. I can't believe I've lost her.
You lost her a long time ago, sir.
Oh, how dare you say that to me? And what's it to use anyway? You are fired.
You may have lost her, sir, but I found her. No, we found each other, and I loved her, sir, like I didn't know I could. I was coming back for her.
Sir, we're waiting for you to make the ID.
I'm coming. We're going. I don't know which.
Gall exits. Mark leans to catch his breath and sees the Route 66 sign. Pulling it from the trash, he reads Selma's note on the back. He stares at it before nodding in response, tucking the sign under his arm. He leaves the bouquet on the counter, and taking the multi-purpose tree and Cali picture, he exits to the sound of birds. Blackout. End of play.